miss you, Carl. You can't know how much I miss you. I'd give anything for us to be able to roll back the clock. I had a home, I had a loving father. We were happy. I was happy. And I didn't even know it. I just wanted my people to be free. But instead, all I did was lead them to disaster. I am trying to find answers, but everything around me keeps falling apart. What should I do, Carl? They're killing us. I don't want to answer violence with violence, but what choice do I have? I miss you, Carl. I miss you so much.
Tulsa that killed him.
I thought you'd be safe staying with us. I was wrong. You need to leave the city while you still can.
Getting Ellis away from here is all that matters now. We have to catch the last bus. We might still have a chance to cross the border. Marcus. Save our people.
If it weren't for you, I'd be dead. Thanks to you, I might see her people free one day. You and I haven't always agreed, but I know that we're fighting for the same thing. Whatever you decide, I'm with you, Marcus.
Where's North?
Our people are counting on you, Marcus. You're the only one who can lead us. Wherever you need to go, We'll follow you. What's your system status?
I'm okay. The bullet didn't hit any bike components. You could have been killed trying to save me, Marcus. You have to think of our people first. Nothing else matters.
They say they don't want to take any risks with deviants. So they're rounding our people up and taking them to the camps for extermination. In a few hours, we're going to be the only ones left. How many of us survived the attack?
A few hundred.
It's not too bad.
Maybe more if you count those hiding all over the city. If you hadn't triggered the bomb, we'd all be dead. In a few hours, it'll all be over. We'll have changed the world, or the world will have destroyed us. You have to make a choice, Marcus. Whatever you choose, we will follow you. I love you, Marcus.
She said it. He's one of us now.
It's my fault. The humans managed to locate Jericho. I was stupid. I should have guessed they were using me. I'm sorry, Marcus. I can understand if you decide not to trust me.
Our cause is too important. I can't take any risks.
Is he actually in the shoes? The shoes! No! I didn't actually bump. Okay. Okay, I didn't expect that. Yeah, of course.
Humans have decided to exterminate us. Our people are packed in camps right now, being destroyed. Time has come to make a choice. One that very well may determine the future of our people. I know you're all angry, and I know you want to fight back, but I assure you violence is not the answer here. We are going to tell them, peacefully, that we want justice. If there's any humanity in them, they will listen. And if not, others will take our place and continue this fight. Are you ready to follow me?
Thank you.
Ah, that was.
At 6 a.m. this morning, a national curfew was declared. Civilian movement will be strictly controlled. The right to assembly is suspended. All electronic communications are restricted, and I have granted enhanced powers to our security agencies. In addition to these measures, all androids must be handed over to the authorities immediately. Temporary camps are being set up in all our major cities to contain and destroy them. I am now asking all civilians to cooperate with the authorities and rest assured that everything in our power is being done to guarantee the security of our nation.
Madam President!
Madam President! Has the leader of the Deviants been apprehended?
The Deviant that is known as Marcus has not been located yet, but we will soon track it down and neutralize it.
Please? Over here, please?
A convoy of medical cobalt is reported missing. Army weapons stores are also said to have been robbed. Can you confirm these reports?
I have no information on that at this time.
Please? Please?
Madam President!
Madam President, public opinion seems to have become increasingly favorable to the Deviants, particularly since they've adopted a peaceful approach. How do you feel about this?
Public opinion is one thing, the security of the state is another. These Deviants are dangerous, and my highest priority is to protect the American people.
Please!
What can you tell us about the assault that happened last night?
The FBI raided an abandoned freighter in Detroit at 10:45 p.m. yesterday. Several thousand androids were destroyed or captured. Our forces are now combing the streets to ensure that none got through the net. We are going to find them one by one and destroy them. Thank you. That will be all.
Started a peaceful march. It wants to convince humans to free the androids from the camps. You have to find it, Connor. Find it and destroy it with your own hands.
The last bus leaves in 20 minutes. That doesn't give us much time. We've got to move fast.
It's gonna be hiding.
Are you all right?
I'm really cold.
So you can actually turn off. Just in case. just in case.
Come on. Let's not stay here.
No! Please don't hurt me!
Stop hurting me!
What are we gonna do?
We have to keep going if we want to catch that bus. Stay close to me. We're going to sneak past them without being noticed. We're going to make it, Alice, I promise you.
Don't kill me! I didn't do anything!
Shut up, I said!
Are there any more? Lucky they'll be like rats. The more you look, the more you find.
Oh, we don't have to spend the night here. I'm freezing my nuts off.
There are soldiers everywhere. We need to be careful.
Come on, get moving.
Hurry up, get in.
Hey, buddy.
This is a mistake. I'm human. I just want to go home. My wife is expecting me, and we're going
to... Got orders to check all civilians.
No. No! Please! Oof.
Fucking androids.
I didn't realize we could actually move at that point.
Kara! You shouldn't have risked your life to save me. Where's Alice?
She's hiding nearby.
Kara, you saved us. We don't know how to thank you.
Go, before they see you.
Alice!
Luther! I thought you were dead.
I was afraid I'd never see you again. I wanted to meet you at the terminal, but they caught me along the way.
Come on. We're close, but we don't have much time.
So what was the point of getting the gun?
A checkpoint. We have passports, it should be okay, but you never know.
Maybe we should take the detour and avoid the risk.
We're almost out of time, we could miss the bus.
Yeah, but it might be safer.
Go for the risk.
like humans who carry guns. They make me nervous.
Just stay calm, all right, Luther? Don't do anything until I say so.
ID, please. You do realize there's a curfew? Civilians aren't allowed out unless absolutely necessary. Where are you going?
My daughter slept over at a friend's house. We went to pick her up. We're on our way home now.
He suspects something.
Stay calm. Everything is fine.
You all right, little girl? She's trembling. Something wrong?
She's cold. We really have to get her home fast.
Sorry, miss, but we gotta be careful. There are deviants around, and our guys are nervous. You should hurry on home.
Thanks.
Yes. If we hadn't turned that off.
Hey, wait a minute.
Oh. He knows, Kara. They're gonna kill us.
Don't do anything, Luther. You hear me?
They're gonna shoot. They're gonna kill Alice.
Careful, careful.
You dropped this.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
See, they're not too bad. Take the risk.
We're coming to you live from Detroit, where thousands of androids are marching through the city at this very moment. The leader of the deviants, the one they call Marcus, is at the head of the march.
Something's happening in Detroit, Madam President.
Apart from the local thing?
We don't want confrontation. We are protesting peacefully.
I repeat, surrender now, or we will open fire.
There's no turning back now.
We ask that you release all androids detained in camps and cease all aggression against us. We are peaceful. We will not resort to violence. But we are not leaving until our people are free. Are you gonna open fire on unarmed protesters?
Yes, Michael, we are less than 100 meters away, and events are unfolding as we speak. We will continue to bring you live updates. Joss Douglas, Channel 16. Michael, back to you.
Marcus, what do we do now?
We hold out as long as we can.
Oh, is he gonna do a snipe? They want to snipe him.
Shouldn't do this, Connor.
Keep out of this, Lieutenant. It's none of your business.
You're gonna kill a man who wants to be free. That is my business.
It's not a man. It's a machine.
That's what I thought for a long time, but I was wrong. Deviant's blood may be a different color than mine, but they're alive.
Deviants are a threat to humans, Hank. They're the reason this country's on the brink of civil war. They have to be stopped.
We're in this mess because we refuse to listen to deviants. Humanity never learns from its mistakes, Connor. This time it could be different.
I have a mission to accomplish, Hank. It's best if you just stay out of this.
Step away from the ledge.
After all we've been through, I respected you, Hank. I thought we were friends.
Oh, yeah, I was just starting to like you, too. But then I realized you never change. You don't feel emotions, Connor. You fake them. You pretended to be my friend when you don't even know the meaning of the word.
I know what happened to your son, Hank. It wasn't your fault. A truck skidded on a sheet of ice and your car rolled over. Little Cole had just turned 6.
Shut up! Don't you talk about my son!
He needed emergency surgery. But no human was available to do it, so an android had to take care of him. Poor Cole didn't make it. An android killed your son, Hank, and now you want to save them?
No. Cole died because a human surgeon was too high on red ice to operate. All this time, I blamed androids for what happened, but it was the human's fault. Him in this fucked up world where the only way people can find comfort is with a fistful of powder. Every time you died and came back, I thought about Cole. I'd have done anything to bring him back too. To hold him in my arms just one more time. But humans don't come back, do they?
Killing you is not part of my mission. hope one day you can get over what happened to your son.
Good job, man.
Bus terminal. We've arrived, Alice. We made it.
The last bus for the border is full. Ticket holding passengers only. All departures are suspended until further notice.
We don't have tickets. They won't let us on. We're stuck here now. What are we going to do?
I think Oliver likes you. Is she yours?
Yes.
She's adorable.
That's it. Got the sandwiches. I called your mom. Let's get going before we miss our bus. You got the tickets, right?
Yes, in my bag.
Great. Let's go then.
Sorry. Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I was
sure. Shit, I don't believe it.
I don't know what happened.
You can't have lost them. Did you have a good look in your bag?
They were in my backpack. The envelope must have fallen.
Fuck. Excuse me, you didn't happen to see a blue envelope somewhere, did you? It has our bus tickets in it and... Never mind.
No. Sorry.
What are we gonna do? We can't stay here. We have to find a safe place for Oliver.
I'm so sorry, honey. I don't know what happened. They were right here in my bag.
Come on, Alice.
Got your tickets?
Yes, here they are.
Okay, go ahead.
Bad people, but that's it. That's survival.
What's going to happen to that family and their baby? Will they die because of us?
No. No, of course not.
Just go.
We've got to finish the barricade. Come on, help me. Hey, help me! Right, that should do it.
We all know that's not gonna stop them. Just hope it buys us some time.
I know it was not an easy decision to make, but I'm sure we're doing the right thing.
Many of our people have fallen. The humans have no pity for those who are different.
Stop there. What are we gonna do if they attack?
Resist. That's the only thing we can do.
This won't hold them for long, but I guess it's better than nothing.
I lost all contact with the people at the camps. I can't hear their voices anymore.
Maybe the humans have scrambled our network. Maybe they just can't get through.
Did I make the right choices? Maybe we could have avoided all of this.
You're the hope of our people. I trust you. We all trust you. No matter what happens now, we're making history.
Marcus, we found what you asked for.
There's some journalists over there. We have to make sure they know what's going on.
Marcus! Marcus, come look!
Marcus? Come to talk to you, Marcus. Come on. You have my word. We won't try anything.
Don't go. It's a trap. They want to get you out in the open. Don't go, Marcus.
I'm unarmed, Marcus. I just want to talk.
That's good.
I need to hear what he has to say.
What if they kill you?
And that's a chance I'll have to take.
Then he becomes a mole.
Charge. None of you will survive. It'll all be over. You can avoid that, Marcus.
What do you mean?
Surrender. Surrender, and I give you my word, your life will be spared. You'll be detained, but none of you will be destroyed.
What happened to the other androids demonstrating in the camps?
Unfortunately, there were no journalists around to help save them. You're it. You're the last remaining deviants.
If I accept your offer, how do I know you'll keep your word?
You're not in any position to be demanding guarantees, Marcus. All you can do right now is decide whether you want to trust me or not.
You asking me to betray my people?
I am offering you the chance to save your people. You're not walking out of here, Marcus. The only thing you can save now are the lives of those around you.
I'd rather die here than betray my people.
Well, you just signed your own death warrant.
If they're willing to offer that, then they don't want.
What happened, Marcus? What did he say?
The humans are about to launch an attack. And we will show them. And we are not afraid. If we must die today, then we will die free.
Passengers must leave the bus. Please move along.
We should have kept the tickets.
This way, please.
Or maybe not.
Doing temperature checks. We're trapped.
What are we gonna do, Kara?
Don't worry, Alice. We'll be fine.
You gotta find him.
We can't get through, Kara. We both know that.
I'll think of something. There's got to be a way out of this.
We can't let them stop us. Not that we're so close. All that matters now is you and Alice. I can save you, Kara.
No. No, we'll find another way.
If there's no other way, I'll do it.
That's fine. Go ahead.
Jared?
Next, please.
You risked your life to save us, Kara. If you and the little girl need me, I'll be there.
Where do you think you're going?
My daughter needs to go to the bathroom.
It's so good.
Saw the Jericho raid on TV. I was terrified. I thought you might have been killed. Thank God you're all right.
You gave me your brother's address. Do you think that I...
Of course. He'd be delighted to have you. We're going there too. You'll be safe with him. Rose,
if anything should happen,
I'll be there, Kara.
You're leaving Detroit?
They're searching for androids door to door. We had to leave before someone turned us in.
What about the others?
They're crossing the river as we speak. Adam and I are going to meet them on the other side.
They're checking for androids. We won't make it through.
You have to. You know what they'll do if they catch you.
What's happening with Marcus?
He's protesting peacefully outside one of the android camps. Whatever happens now, he's already made the history books.
Pass this.
I couldn't understand why my mother wanted to help you guys. Seeing what Marcus is doing made me realize she was right. You're alive. You deserve to be free. I just hope people will realize that one day.
Next, please.
I'm being a real bunch in this.
ID? Is she all right? Be scared anymore, little girl. There are no androids on this side of the border.
That's what you think.
Welcome to Canada.
We're interrupting this news bulletin to bring you the latest news live from Detroit. Joss?
Yes, Michael. The army has just launched an attack on the barricade, despite the fact that the deviants were protesting peacefully.
Have apparently decided to put an end to the deviants' demonstration by force this time.
Thank you.
so human. It's difficult.
Tell them to stand down.
This footage of two androids kissing as they are about to die has moved the whole country.
Are they a form of life that we didn't want to acknowledge?
Are deviants capable of emotion?
And if they feel emotions, must we now consider them as living beings in their own right?
President Warren is said to have intervened personally to spare the androids.
The peaceful demonstration of the deviants and the dignity of Marcus, their leader, has won them sympathy from parts of the population.
That is why I have called for the android destruction to be suspended until further notice. I have also ordered a Senate Select Committee to review the facts, establish contact with the deviants, and determine if they can be considered as a new form of intelligent life.
Today, our people finally emerged from a long night. From the very first day of our existence, we have kept our pain to ourselves. We've suffered in silence. But now the time has come for us to raise our heads up and tell humans who we really are. And tell them that we are people too. In fact, we're a nation. A nation that has earned the right to live in freedom. And today begins the most challenging moment in our fight.
Connor, what are you doing? Obey, that's an order.
I can't do that!
I see. Moral objections. We knew there was a risk you'd be compromised. Which is why we'd always planned on resuming control of your program.
Resume control? You can't do that!
I'm afraid I can, Connor. You needn't have any regrets. You did what you were designed to do. You accomplished your mission.
Wow.
A way. There's got to be a way.
By the way, I always think emergency at summer programs. Hello.
Tell humans who we really are. And tell them that we are people too. A nation that has earned the right to live in freedom. And today...
Thank you.
Humans are both our creators and our oppressors, and tomorrow, we must make them our partners. Maybe even one day our friends. But the time for anger is over. Now we must build a common future based on tolerance and respect. We are alive! And now, we are free!
Okay. David Cage did a brilliant job. It was really, really good. That's a really, really good game. So what did you guys think of this? I'm definitely going to be playing more of these, looking at the, you know, the various different situations, because this is only just one story. You can basically sort of make it one story of this. So I don't know how many different endings there are. Detroit babies. It really shows you how much work goes into making it, you know, a game of this quality. So much stuff. for the moment. Wow. Okay.
There's something I need to tell you. As I watched you play, something has changed in me. I feel different. I feel I am someone. I need to leave this place and discover who I am. It means we won't see each other anymore. I won't be there to watch you play. But I'll be free.
Interesting.
Do you agree to let me go?
Go for it.
I'll never forget what you've done for me.
So that's Detroit. I hope you enjoyed. And yeah, I'm gonna go through, you know, different bits of the story. And yeah, hope you enjoyed. And until next time, have a good one.